I could nap all day. It said Netanyahu lost, loses his 12 years as president.
Thank you.
TD, could you get me a box of tissue? They're right under the thing.
Oh, the tissues?
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Jesus Christ. Shit. You follow the news, like world news? Netanyahu is out of power now in Israel.
Never go and tell them my name. This is some social that you need to. Turn out to be a yellow. my mom thought that we should resume operations, you know, maybe just start delivering basic food again with whatever minimum staff we have. During that time, one of our regular customers, Mr. Abhinav, he approached me saying that, Harsh, I wanted to, you know, feed 100 poor people, but I don't want to step out because of the lurking coronavirus risk. So can you go out and do that for me? So I was like, yeah, okay. Like, you know, like I've been delivering food all my life. So let's do this as well. I put up an appreciation post on my social media, and that post kind of connected with the people online, and people started donating money, and from that day it just didn't stop. In the year 1998, I lost my father to a car accident, and I was just 5, and my mom was 27 years old back then. So as a means of survival and earning livelihood, she started with different services at home on a friend's suggestion. Ma used to cook and I used to deliver. So it goes with that tagline that is mom makes and sells, because it's always been like that. There's no stability in people's life, especially the middle class people, you know, who are surviving hand to mouth on day-to-day basis, the daily wage earners, etc. They are living in very uncertain times.
If you want to go, you can.
No, but I still have like 14 minutes and I have to have you sign out.
Okay.
Yeah, so. I'm just kind of tired of sitting down.
That never happens to me. Oh, I have to clock out on your phone.
Yeah. You have to sign my timesheet and you have to sign on the phone.
Gotcha, gotcha.
About in 1992 when actually tried to take his own life. And he was found, and I spoke to him about 6 months later, and he had an extremely difficult phone call, and since then we have had no contact. The repercussions of all the changes and the release of so much information were huge, not just for people in Costa Rica who got to learn just how closely watched she'd been. There was fallout for those who'd done the spying too. Informants' names were now known to friends, family, and the public. In the early 1990s, many asked whether the Stasi files were opened too soon and too fully, while others insisted that the country continue to seek the full truth about Stasi repression, no matter how painful. While many of the names in Ulrika's files were familiar to her, there was one that cropped up everywhere that was new: Lieutenant Detlef Schiller. He was the Stasi officer in charge of her case. This man had, for years, followed the detailed records of Ulrika's life, and now it was her turn to track him down. With the help of her friend,
can you help me get my shawl on?
Well, it's a strange story, actually. So, Monica, who's the woman who had been informing on us in the...
I really appreciate the extra help this week.
She had found an announcement in the newspaper. A man was looking for a job, and she noticed that the telephone number was exactly the same as the Stasi officer that she used to work with. And she told this to a friend, and he told me about this. And so I asked a friend of mine in West Berlin, a lawyer friend who was working for a pharmaceutical company, to call this number and make a job offer. And so in that way, the former Stasi officer came to the pharmaceutical company thinking he was being offered a job, invited for a job interview. And my lawyer friend met with him and invited him back a second time. And on that occasion, my lawyer friend took the former Stasi officer to a pub around the corner to essentially say welcome to the company, and said he'd invite him for a beer. And I was in that pub, I was waiting kind of behind a wall, and I heard my friend say to the Stasi officer, I actually have a friend in East Berlin who claims you were a Stasi officer. And obviously this guy was really scared, and then suddenly I was being pushed towards the table, and I just wanted to run away, to be honest, but I did stand there and I talked to him, and I told him, it's really unfair that you know so much about me and I know nothing about you. And after that we ordered a schnapps together, and we sat and we talked, and I actually met him about 5 times after that.
Und dann haben wir Schnäpse bestellt beim Ober, haben geredet.
And was he what you expected?
Ich weiß nicht.
I don't know. I've met quite a few different people at the Stasi over the years. And this man was my age, so he was younger than a lot of the other Stasi officers. And he told me that there was a kind of split or conflict within the Stasi at the end between the hardliners, who were the kind of older guard, and then the younger people who, you know, were maybe a little bit more open to new ideas. I wasn't really sure if I could trust him, to be honest. But he was someone who was thoughtful, and he was intelligent, and he was regretful about what he'd done. And he told me his perspective, so how he had seen the whole thing, what it was like for him, his motivations. And, you know, it was really interesting for me to talk to him. And he tried to get a foothold in this new life after 1989, but it just didn't really work.
Detlef Schiller and Ulrika stayed in touch. Ulrika embraced her new work.
I messed up the trash bag. Do you think you could take the Coke I threw in there and pour it out and... I threw a soda that was not empty in there and messed it all up.
Oh.
Oh, thank you.
No I'll go get the timesheet for you to sign afterwards.
I didn't hear you.
I said I'll get the timesheet for you to sign after that.
Okay. Excuse me.
There you go.
Okay. Thanks for everything, Dee Dee. Oh, gotcha.
No problem.
Have a good weekend. Laugh next weekend.
I will try to.
Sleep the whole time.
I pretty much slept most of the day yesterday, and then I was up all night pretty much reading and just doing whatever. So, I got everything. All right, you have a good week.
You too.
And I'll see you when I see you.
Okay.
All right, have a good night.
You too. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Yeah.
I'm glad I didn't shut the door all the way.
Oh, thank you.
No problem.
Oh, yeah. I reaffirm all requests for all Satanists. Affirm, reaffirm, firm, reaffirm, firm, reaffirm, firm, reaffirm, to the power of an infinite number of infinities. Thank you. Oh, fuck. Reaffirm all requests for all statements. Affirm, reaffirm, affirm, reaffirm. Affirm, reaffirm, affirm, reaffirm. Affirm, reaffirm, affirm, reaffirm. To the power of an infinite number of infinite. I ask for a zone of protection, God. A 6-foot zone of protection. Affirm, reaffirm. Affirm, reaffirm. Affirm, reaffirm. Power of an infinite number of infinity. Shit. My ears were. Dee Dee made a pot of coffee. don't have much wax in my ears. Mm-mm.